Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome to Let's Demo. This week back, well not back, we're on the PS4. We're gonna take a look at our very first PS4 demo. We've done a couple quick plays on here, but now it's time for a demo, and it is gonna be Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist. I think I tricked you out there with Indivisible for a second. Don't worry, we'll get there. Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist. I have been a fan of Yu-Gi-Oh! For a very long time, and recently went to see The Dark Side of Dimensions in theaters with my girlfriend and Brandon. So, I downloaded the demo for this. Let's jump in. Oh, I have Attack on Titan open. I don't think I was doing anything important. Well, I hope I wasn't. Hope I wasn't in the middle of a mission or something. Now, Legacy of the Duelist combines the first five main arcs of Yu-Gi-Oh! Of course, Duel Monsters, GX, 5Ds, Zexal, and Arc V. So, wow, this came out in 2014. Alright, let's jump in here. Unlock full game is, of course, pay for it, help and options, blah blah blah. Let's jump into single player. And campaign. I know how to play Yu-Gi-Oh! So, what are these symbols? I only really know this one. Oh. I guess my internet's not working yet again. What is gonna jump into regular Yu-Gi-Oh? The Duelist Kingdom. Let's go. Loading Yu-Gi-Oh! Histories. Oh, it's a robot. I'm not gonna do a robot voice. The story of Yugimoto begins at Domino High School, where Duel Monsters, the hottest card game in the world, was all the rage. Yugi was the best duelist around, and his friend Joey wanted desperately to learn how to duel as well. So our history of Yugimoto starts with Yugi teaching the rules of Duel Monsters to Joey as their friends Taya and Tristan watch.
Hey Joey, Earth to Joey, it's your turn.
Oh, isn't he cute when he's thinking?
Hey Tristan, Yugi here is trying to teach me how to play Duel Monsters.
Drooling Monsters?
Duel Monsters, you Nimrod.
They've been at it for hours. Joey's starting to get the hang of the game, but Yugi's like an expert.
Okay, Yugi, it's time to duel.
So, I like to think of myself as somewhat decent at the Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged voices. But it's kind of late right now, so I can't be that loud, so I can't really portray these voices too great. But anyway, wow, what a stirring intro. Infinite. Okay, Shuriken spin a tail. Greetings, duelist. I am Informate. Oh, okay. Informate. Okay. Part of the Virtual Game Simulator, I have been programmed to teach you proper dueling rules and best practices. Sir, I know how to play. I would have jumped into the tutorial if I wanted you to teach me. So, it's a tutorial, isn't it? I know how to play. I'll let you pause and read all of this stuff if you're really interested. We are gonna summon... Oh, it wants me to summon Dragon Dwelling in the Cave. We'll summon it then. Wait, it wants me to set it? I want to summon it. Well, I guess it does have 2,000 defense points. Now we're going to the end phase. Alright. It has been a while since I played any Yu-Gi-Oh! Games. I've been playing Duel Links on my phone, and it's a lot of fun. I highly recommend it. Oh, you actually... It's a good job I set it. So, for those of you who don't understand Yu-Gi-Oh!, it's a children's trading card game, for lack of a better term. And you have your monsters, which go in the top five areas. It wants me to play Banner of Courage. I have this, actually, in Duel Links. And the bottom five are your spell and trap cards. Does it want me to set this? I guess I'm setting Call of the Haunted. So, why would I switch it to attack position? Well, clearly it knows what it wants me to do. Summon Ninkendog. Oh. Alright, we're gonna summon Ninkendog. And he's gonna, because of the spell card I activated, he's gonna gain 200 attack points. Because if we read this, all monsters you control gain 200 attack during your battle phase. We're now in the battle phase, so Ninkendog is up to 2,000, so we can destroy him who is in attack mode. And if a monster that is in attack mode gets destroyed by another monster attacking it, then the difference in attack points is dealt to your life points. If your monster is in defense mode and gets destroyed, you don't take any damage. So yeah, let's end the phase. Now, if, say you attack a monster that's got a higher attack points than you, your monster's getting destroyed. If you attack a monster that has higher defense points than you, then I don't believe your monster gets destroyed. I actually don't remember that, but you do take damage based on the difference. Alright, so it wants us to do a tribute monster, summon. Tribute summon. So, because of its level, this thing is level 6. We must tribute, I believe, one card. Yeah, one monster. It wants us to get rid of Ninkendog, even though he's the more powerful one. So, alright. We get rid of him, and we can summon Gravicrush Dragon. If we read this card description, it has an effect we can trigger. So you can send one face-up continuous spell card you control to the graveyard, then select one monster your opponent controls and destroy it. Okay, so we're going to activate that effect. That's going to let us send Banner of Courage to the graveyard, and we can destroy his monster. Cool. Why would I want to... It wants me to do that. Oh, we can do Call of the Haunted now. I forgot I set that. So we can activate this trap, and that allows us to bring back Ninkendog. Do I want to activate another one? Okay. And then I guess I'm also activating Rush Recklessly. I was gonna do that anyway, but... Okay. So we chained those together. I was just gonna do that next, but whatever. So now we have all these monsters on the field. And now we're ready to attack. So let's go to the battle phase. And just go in on Joey's life points. He's gonna lose 1800. He's gonna lose another 1300. And then he's gonna lose 3100. Exactly. I only know that because I've seen a lot of videos on this game, so... What? A card that powerful totally wipes me out!
Whoa, you stink at this game, Joey!
You did fine, Joey. I just have better cards. My grandpa owns a game shop, and I get all my best cards from him.
What? You own a game shop? What are we waiting for? Let's go!
Okay, maybe I can even get my grandpa to show us the super rare card he's got.
Little did they know that- Oh, look who it is. Little did they know that someone was listening in on their conversation. Someone who was looking for a very rare card to add to his collection. Oh, we did it. We unlocked Joey as a new duelist, as a deck avatar. We have 7 out of 100 of them. New deck recipe, Joey Wheeler Monster Raider. We got Axe Raider, who's actually a really good basic monster. This thing. Snowman Eater, what? And some duel points. New duel. Alright, we're gonna get to that in a second. I wanna see what this is. Damn it, I just wanna know what it is. Okay, we're moving on to the heart of the cards. That afternoon, Yugi and his friends went to Grandpa's game shop. Yugi wanted to show his friends his grandpa's prized possession. Gramps, could you show my friends your super awesome chocolatey fudge coated super ultra mega super card?
Rare card? You mean my special card?
Please, please.
Haha, how could I refuse? You kids are in for a treat. I don't take this card out too often. Ready? Here it is. The Blue Eyes Whitey Dragon. The Blue Peeps Whitey Dragon. So rare, so powerful, I never let it leave my hands. This card is priceless. There are only 4 of them in all the world.
Why does it not have a card description?
Or a name?
Suddenly, a classmate from school ran into the shop. His name was Seto Kaiba, the young CEO of Kaiba Corp. He had found the card he was looking for.
Name your price for that Blue Eyes. I can pay anything you ask.
I'm sure you could, but this card is worth more to me than you could ever offer.
Senile old fool.
Kaiba stormed out of Grandpa's store. The team was disturbed by Kaiba's obsession with Blue Eyes White Dragon. The next day, when Yugi came back to the store with his friends, he found Grandpa was gone. When the phone rang, it was Kaiba on the other end, mocking Yugi that he kidnapped his grandfather and took him to Kaiba Corp. Yeah, this happens. He abducts an old man. Yugi and his friends rushed to Kaiba Corp and found Grandpa laying on the floor, defeated.
Grandpa, are you okay?
Yugi, I failed. I wanted to teach that boy Kaiba a lesson about the heart of the cards, but I lost.
Grandpa!
How's the old man feeling,
Kaiba, you sleaze! What have you done to him?
We had a duel, that's all. With each of us putting up our most valuable card as the prize. But I guess playing against a champion like myself was just too much stimulation for the old fool.
Kaiba, you should be ashamed of yourself!
Look at the sweet prize I won.
Kaiba held up Grandpa's Blue Eyes White Dragon and ripped it in half.
Grandpa's most treasured card!
Blue Eyes White Dragon is a rare and powerful card, and this one will never be used against me.
My Blue Eyes White Dragon! My treasure!
Grandpa, hold on!
How could you do such a thing?
Yugi, take this!
Huh? Grandpa?
I built this deck. I put my soul in these cards, and I taught you everything you know, Yugi. Take my cards and teach Kaiba respect for the heart of the cards.
Okay, Grandpa, I'll do it. I love how Taya is just still there at the side.
Are you ready to play, runt?
Playtime is over, Kaiba.
Huh?
Kaiba was taken aback by Yugi's sudden transformation. It seemed like he had become a different person, as if he was more confident and powerful than before.
Kaiba, prepare yourself, because it's time to duel.
Oh boy, let's go. What is that? What is synchro summoning? I don't know.
I just like classic Yu-Gi-Oh, if that's okay. We lost, we're going second, but that doesn't actually matter.
Never mind, he wants us to go first. Nope, he wants us to go second. Alright. Going second isn't all that bad, because you can't attack on your first turn unless you go second. So, yeah.
Ooh!
Got a lot of spell cards. Some decent spell cards, too, actually. Alright, let's see. We draw. We got Swords of Revealing Light, which flips all monsters that your opponent controls, and then they can't attack for 3 turns. We're gonna activate that right away, because he has a set monster. It has four... Oh, it's Ancient Lamp. During your main phase, you can special summon Lejin. The card must be face up on the field to activate and resolve this effect. Before damage, blah, blah, blah. Just down to the start, your damage step, you can target one monster. Okay, you know what? We're gonna just keep going. We're gonna go with Raigeki to destroy all monsters your opponent controls. So, I mean, this was maybe a waste, but whatever. During a draw phase, when you draw a normal monster, you can reveal it. Draw one more card. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So that's gonna be active for us. I'm gonna also use Pot of Greed, which allows us to draw 2 more cards. Hello. And Sangan. So Kaiba can't attack. If this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, add one monster with 1500 or less attack from your deck to your hand, but you cannot activate cards or the effects of cards with that name for the rest of this turn. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and summon Sangan. Because he can't attack us for 3 turns, so he may as well. And we're gonna do 1000 points of damage to him. Never mind, he has negate attack. And I'm not about to explain that, because it's called negate attack.
Are you explaining negate attack to me?
Alright, what are you gonna do, Kaiba? 1 card face down, and nothing else. Turn 1 of swords is up. Oh, I have another one. Alright then. In that case, normally with Giant Soldier of Stone, I would set it, because it's got 2,000 defense points. But we're gonna summon it, because he still can't attack us. And we're gonna fight him with our Giant Soldier of Stone. Alright, he has nothing else he can do. Never mind, he was waiting. Activate this card by targeting one face-up... Could I read that, please? One face-up monster your opponent controls. It loses 700 attack. Also, it cannot attack or change battle position. When it leaves the field, destroy this card. So our Giant Soldier of Stone now can't do anything, and I can't put it in defense mode. Okay. So that's kind of sucky. Lejin. Hey, you can't attack me yet, though, Kaiba. I don't have anything to attack him with, though. We got another Giant Soldier of Stone. Yeah, I'm gonna activate Heart of the Underdog. You can see that I have another one. And I got Karibo! Karibo's pretty good. Read its effect right there. You can discard it to avoid taking damage, basically. But what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna activate Dark Hole. Destroy all monsters on the field, including ours. We can't do anything. There we go. But now Sangan, hello. I didn't realize it was from our deck. Maybe I read that wrong. So we can now bring something from our deck. We have all these pieces of the fabled Exodia, the Forbidden One. I kinda wanna play this out. Read his effect here. If you have all of his pieces, you win the duel. So, yeah, but I don't think I'm gonna actually try and draw for Exodia, because you don't get any kind of special cutscene or anything that plays. I'm gonna go with Celtic Guardian. Let's bring him out. And we have 1 turn left on this, so, whoops. I'm gonna go ahead and summon Celtic Guardian. And we're gonna go to the battle phase, because he can't do anything to us right now. Wait, why didn't Sangan do extra 1000 points of damage? I must have missed something there, but alright. Turn change. Here we go. What have you got for me, Kaiba? Nothing at all. Kaiba, you're not gonna be able to do anything to me, are you? We got another Dark Hole. I'm gonna activate my second swords. I'm gonna summon a leg.
You're gonna get beaten down by a leg with 200 attack points. I don't even care. We're doing this. We're gonna attack you with my Celtic Guardian. And we're gonna attack you with the right leg of Exodia. For an extra 200. How's that feel, Kaiba? How does that feel? Alright, let's see. Okay, he finally summoned a monster. What else do we have? We also drew another Dark Hole. Oh, there's another Sangan. Can we check our deck? No, I don't want to surrender. We can't actually look at our deck here, so I don't know what Yugi has. I'm going to go ahead and summon Sangan. Because we can. I feel like it. How many turns do we have left on this? Alright. We actually should be good here. As long as this doesn't have more than 1,400, we should be able to destroy it. It has 2,000. We can't do anything on this turn. Alright, he actually got something decent. So, unless we can somehow turn that into attack position, or he's gonna tribute it to summon Judge Man. Okay. That's two turns of that up. So, ooh, we got summoned Skull. So we get to show him that we got that. And we drew another one. Yep, I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna keep going. We got another one. I'm gonna keep doing it to see what we can get. Another one. Yugi, why do you have so many regular-ass monsters in your deck? Oh my god. There's also a limit on how many cards you can have in your hand. Are we seriously? We're still going. Oh my god. Are we gonna get Exodia? Holy crap. Exodia, please. Oh my god. We have three pieces of Exodia. Oh, we got the Sangan. We have so many cards in our hand right now. I'm summoning Dark Magician. I don't care. It's Yugi's signature card. We're gonna tribute Sangan, and I'll tribute Celtic Guardian, just in case we somehow draw the rest of Exodia. So he's on there. He's on the field. Oh my god. I'm gonna bring this piece of Exodia out. Holy crap, we might actually get Exodia. So that we used up our summon for this turn. We can only summon one monster per turn. Look how many monsters we have on the field. I'm gonna put him to defense position. And we're gonna go to the battle phase. Destroy that Judge Man. Yeah! This is why I wanted to summon Dark Magician, because he's actually got a cool cutscene. A little animation that plays. Alright, so now, when we end our turn, it's gonna make us discard some cards. How many do we have to get rid of? I actually don't know. Rude Kaiser I'll keep. I'm gonna get rid of Torike. We'll get rid of Horn Imp. We'll get rid of... I don't want to get rid of any Exodia pieces. We'll get rid of another Sangan. Actually, I shouldn't have done that. Should have kept Sangan because I could have destroyed him and then drew the last piece. We'll get rid of you. Oh my god, so many. We'll get rid of Mystical Elf because we have the Giant Soldier. And I guess Darkhole. We have to keep going? Alright. Rude Kaiser. There we go. Wow. That was ridiculous. We have four pieces of Exodia. Just because we've gotten so close, I kind of do want to see if we can get the rest of Exodia. Let's see. Hello. Increase your life points by 300 points for each monster on the field. You just activated that trap. Alright. Equip to a monster your opponent controls. Take control of the equipped monster. During each of your opponent's standby phases, they gain 1,000 life points. Equip only to a monster your opponent controls. Can I not... it won't let me activate that yet. Strange. Alright, I'm gonna set this. And... oh god, I don't want him to destroy this leg. I'm kind of regretting placing that on the field now, but... let's go. Let's attack him with Dark Magician. Saggy the Dark Clown. Yeah, take him down, Dark Magician. Dark Magic Attack. Alright, and that's gonna be the end of the turn. Let's see, what do you have, Kaiba? I may just wait this out. We only have 14 cards left in the deck. Oh, that was it. Are you sweating, Kaiba? We have another one of these? Sure, I'll activate a second one. And then... do I want to summon Karibo? I'm gonna summon Karibo. I don't care, I'm summoning Karibo. And I'm gonna leave him in defense position. We're gonna do a little bit of damage here. Attack with Dark Magician. We'll attack with Karibo. And now we're gonna end our turn. We have 3 Exodia pieces in our hand, 1 on the field, probably a bunch of monsters left, stop defense. Are you planning on taking out my leg? No? Why'd you even use that then? Alright. Spellbinding Circle. Activate this card by targeting one monster your opponent controls. It cannot attack or change its battle position. I'm gonna set that. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn that back to defense position for one thing. We're gonna go to the battle phase. And we are gonna attack it with Karibo, because it, yeah, that's not gonna kill it. It's the Hitatsumi Giant. Then we're gonna go to main phase 2. I can activate this now. That's mine now. Yes, and now we have a full field. I just really hope he doesn't summon something and decide to attack the freaking leg. And he's also gonna gain some, oh, he got Pot of Greed, okay. Watch him just, oh wait, can I? Hello? Really? Uh-huh. Get Spellbound. What is this? What did he get? Sword Stalker. Alright, that's, he can't do anything right now, so. Oh my god. Wait. We got all 5 pieces. Does it not work because it's on the field? It's letting me do it twice. I got a 3rd one. I don't think we can win. I can't do it. If you have it and left one of the forbidden one, it is just got in your hand. Because I summoned the leg, we can't win with Exodia. That sucks. Alright, I'm gonna tribute his monster. And we'll tribute Karibo. Oh, never mind, we only have to tribute one. I'm a little mad about that, I'm not gonna lie. A little bit mad about that. Take out Ryukishin. We're gonna attack with Karibo as well. And cause I feel like it. Well, we only have 9 cards in our deck. I don't care. We're waiting this out another turn. I know we can't do it. I'm kind of mad that I didn't read the effect fully. He has something. Let's see. Also, if you run out of cards in your deck, you lose. So, I swear, if I lose here, we're gonna activate 3 of these. I don't care. I'm doing it. We're drawing 3 more cards. And he's gonna do Gift of the Mystical Elf again. Oh my god. I should probably stop doing this, otherwise I'll probably lose. Okay. I'll activate the swords. I mean, if Yugi didn't have so many freaking monsters in his deck. Alright, and let's do this. Let's end it. Let's just end it right here. Attack with Summon Skull. We're gonna let my leg attack again. Because it's just kind of been chilling there. We're gonna let Karibo attack again. And then I think Dark Magician's gonna end it off. With his Dark Magic attack, boom. We could have won with Exodia. That is a thing that could have happened. But it didn't. Well, you play only for power, Kaiba. That is why you lost. But if you put your heart in the game, there's nothing you can't do. I can't really do Yami's voice. The results of the duel spread quickly, and a mysterious one-eyed man gets news of Yugi's victory. It seems Kaiba Boy has been defeated in a duel. I must learn more about this Yugi Moto. I wonder who that could be. And we unlocked the reverse duel, so we can do that the other way around. We got Kaiba, of course. And Blue Eyes. Sweet. Should we do another duel? I think we'll move on. Oh, we can't. Could we do the reverse duel? We can't do the reverse duel. That's it for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Section of it. You know what? I think we're actually going to go ahead and end this Let's Demo here. We're at about 25 minutes, and to be honest, after GX, I never really paid much attention to Yu-Gi-Oh! So I don't know what's coming up in these later ones. It is kind of a big demo, though, if you want to do the rest of it. You got all these different duels you can do. I believe you get 10 total duels. Oh, that's what I'm guessing, because we got 2 in the regular one, so I would assume so, but I highly recommend this game. If you've played Yu-Gi-Oh! Before, if you've watched Yu-Gi-Oh! Before, I definitely recommend it because it does follow the anime and you get to use the decks from the anime, so I can certainly recommend it. And we basically won with Exodia, let's be real. But anyway, That, folks, is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Let's Demo. If you guys enjoyed, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comments section below. Yeah, you're going to have to unfortunately wait another month until the next episode of Let's Demo, which will possibly be indivisible, but we shall see. So, thank you all once again for watching, stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.